will require employers to post their wages. It can be on the bulletin board, it can be in the news media, whatever they want to do at work. The top, the mid, and the bottom, because if that had been some information that I could have had access to, I would have known earlier, it wouldn't have carried me all the way back on 19 years. But when I was making below the minimum, because it really, if you know, I couldn't let it go. I was 2 years away from retiring, or 2 years forced me out. I lost the age discrimination case. But at least I could file the charge earlier and maybe made a little difference in my retirement. But this has really been a battle. It's hard on an individual. It's hard on our families. It's hard on your neighbors because they'll sort of take sides. Once you get into a controversy situation, no matter what it is, people will criticize because they don't know the whole story. And I won't lie to you. I was pretty devastated by the court's decision, but people have been good. I've had numerous calls in my community where the people based on their informant cannot come out publicly and support the president that I did last year or support the Ledbetter bill, but they're behind the scenes sending emails and writing letters because they do support it. They understand it. As they told you in the beginning, we'll open it up for questions because as many groups as I speak to, I try to cover everything. But I can answer the first question before you ask it. No, I do not know who left the anonymous note. More than likely, it could have been a union person, because I never knew. It could have been a janitor who came across the information and knew I didn't know that. It could have been one of my former bosses who couldn't do anything about my pay and wanted to let me know it. And Goodyear tried to say at trial that I was a poor performer, but I had been selected in the early 90s to start up the light truck radio, and then in 1996, they gave me a top performance award. And they kept me for 19 years and 10 months. So it was sort of hard to prove, and when the judge asked for my personnel file, I said they didn't have one. He said, look, let me explain the law to you people. Evidently, your attorneys don't know. When a person files a charge, the record for that person is kept on file until the case is settled. He says, then you can throw it away. That's what you want to do. But Goodyear really didn't really do evaluations until they were having a downsize or a layoff. Any questions out there?
I'm astounded, you guys.
I know.
You mentioned when you were talking about your fellow supervisors were white men. Was there discrimination based on race as well?
Yes. You know? Yes, sir. One of my people who came to the court to testify, we didn't use him, was an African American, and he actually had a law degree, but he was doing the same job I was. And he told me later that everybody, he was not in this area where I was at, he was in the shooting down the final finish area, I was in the tire room. But he said that he and all the African Americans, even in quality control, and all of the women was called to the plant manager's office. I know he had been given $1,000 a month raise when the headlines hit. And I understand later, I traveled with the group to Washington for the inauguration this past year, my daughter and I did. The two girls from Akron, Ohio brought me a message from a girl who had transferred from Gadsden to Ohio plant, and she sent me a thank you for her raise. So evidently they did it across the country because I'm sure they got some more investigation. started somewhere else. There were easier places to start. But the guy, all he told her was, she's crazy as hell for wanting that job. And so after a month, she goes to the plant manager to ask when did she get her difference in her clerk in the area manager's salary she was promised. He said, we're not giving you a damn dime. So she said, I'll take my clerk's job back. She got a promotion and several big raises, and Goodyear also hired the attorney that they had hired, and he was very, the most expensive one in Birmingham, to represent them, but he lost. And they still hired him to go to Washington to teach the other people, managers, when they brought them all, the Akron, to teach them how to not let this happen again. Of course, I would have said it early on for $60,000. I offered it